This month, we're talking about leadership. And my title this morning is Leadership is Everything. Leadership is Everything. I just want to encourage you to open up your heart and then be ready and be willing. Desire to learn something this month, because God just wants to help us and move us to another level. Praise the Lord. Isaiah chapter 3, verse 4 to 8. Isaiah chapter 3, verse 4 to 8. I will give children to be their princes, that's their leaders, and babies shall rule over them. Okay? And the people shall be oppressed, everyone by another, and everyone by his neighbor. The child shall behave himself rudely against the ancient, and the base against the honorable. Okay? When a man shall take a hold of his brother, of the house of his father, saying, you have clothing, be our ruler, and let this reign be under your hand. In that day shall he swear, saying, I will not be an healer or a ruler, for in my house is neither bread nor clothing. Make me not a ruler over the people. Praise the Lord. So God is talking here about a time coming when, because his people will misbehave, okay, or because his people are misbehaving, he said, I will give babies and children to be their leaders and their princes. Praise the Lord. And then he began to talk about the effects. He said, Jerusalem will be in ruins. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. People will be so hungry. The person they think that he has enough, they will go to him, please, can you bring us together and be our leader? And he will say, no, even myself, I'm still hungry. Praise the Lord. There will be scatter everywhere. Now, leadership is everything. Somebody say leadership is everything. And I don't need to belabor this. If you didn't know leadership is everything, look at Nigeria. Glory to Jesus. In case you didn't know, or the sense is not making coming together for you, just look at our situation in this country. Praise the Lord. I said, praise God. Okay, so, and then look at some other countries where leadership is working, and then you see the what I'm saying. Praise the Lord. Listen, the difference between John C. Maxwell put it this way. He said, everything rises and falls on leadership. Everything. An individual life is accomplished, it's leadership. An individual life is not accomplished, it's leadership. A home is stable, it's leadership. A home is not stable, it's leadership. An organization is working, that's leadership you are looking at. Organization is not working, that's leadership. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. A church is moving forward, leadership. A church isn't moving forward, leadership. A nation is working, that's leadership. A nation is not working, you are looking at leadership. Praise the Lord. Leadership is so very extremely important. And this month, as we look at it, I don't want you to ignore the things you are going to learn. Every one of us has some improvement or some, yes, improvement to do in the area of leadership. Praise God. I'm believing that God will take you and I by the hand this month, and then he will teach us some of the things that we need to know in order to move to our next level. Let me tell your neighbor, your next level is around the corner. Say it again, your next level is around the corner. Now, what is leadership? What is leadership? The capacity, we are going to be fast, the capacity to make people follow you or make people go in the direction that you are going through inspiration and influence. Capacity to make people go in the same direction with you through inspiring them and influencing them. Not by coercion or manipulation. Not by coercion or manipulation. Not by force. By inspiring them and also motivating them. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. And I see God use you and I. God is going to raise leaders of hundreds in our church. Leaders of thousands in the name of Jesus. Every authentically great person who you see is great in leadership. Every person who is great authentically, I'm careful in using the word success, Because in this day and age, we have come to misunderstand success. Praise the Lord. Once I say every successful person, we think every somebody that has money. And that's not true. Praise the Lord. If somebody has all the world as money and he's stealing it, he's not getting it by rights, he's not successful. He can be successful in the eyes of you and I, but in Jehovah's sight, he's not successful. Praise the Lord. So people who are authentically successful or accomplished, anybody, whether in Nigeria, outside Nigeria, any part of the world, you are seeing somebody who has learned one or two things about leadership. Praise the Lord. Leadership is so very powerful. There are two aspects to leadership. And then we're going to discuss one of them. And then we'll take the other services to discuss the other one. There is first self-leadership before others' leadership. Two aspects of leadership. Self-leadership. Leadership starts by leading yourself first. Remember how I define leadership? Making people to go in the direction, in the same direction with you. Jesus said, follow me. Praise the Lord. Making people to go in the same direction with you. Okay, you are going in a direction and it's desirable, and then you are helping others to come along with you. That is leadership. So first and foremost, leadership involves self-leadership. Somebody say self-leadership. Anybody who hasn't gotten, okay, let's put it this way. If you don't get self-leadership, you can never get leadership. If you do not get self-leadership, you can never ever get leadership. Leadership starts with leading yourself first. If you can't lead yourself, you can't possibly lead others. Am I communicating? Is somebody here this morning? Praise the Lord. Self-leadership is the foundation of leadership. It is the infrastructure of leadership. It is the part of leadership. You may not see it, but it is there. Self-leadership. Being able to make yourself go in an area or in a direction that you desire to go in. Many people want, many people want to be wealthy. Many people want to be successful. Many people want to be accomplished, but they cannot bring themselves to do the things that they need to do in order to be accomplished. So that's lack of self-leadership right there. Praise the Lord. I said praise the Lord. So what is self-leadership, please? Do not mind that we are making a lot of definitions. Praise the Lord. Self-leadership is the capacity to influence, motivate, manage, mobilize, and harness oneself. The capacity to influence, to motivate, to manage yourself, to mobilize yourself, to harness, in order to harness all the things, all the other things you have, yourself, that's self-leadership. And that's where success starts from. This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but you, somebody say you, shall meditate in it day and night. For then you shall observe to do according to all that's written therein, and then you shall have good success. Praise the Lord. Many years ago, my friend Nia Adesanya preached a sermon when we're in this town, and the sermon was, try to spell success without you. I've forgotten how he coined it, but that was the sermon. Can you ever spell success without the word, the letter U? Is it possible? It is not possible. Success is impossible without you. It starts with you. And at the end of the day, it almost also ends with you. Praise the Lord. Is somebody still here? So what is self-leadership very quickly? Did you write it down? What is self-leadership? Praise the Lord. Glory to Jesus. I said glory to Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Self-leadership, I will also be referring to it as self-mastery. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Glory to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let's run this morning. Let's run. Praise the Lord. There are seven pillars of self-leadership. Seven pillars of self-leadership. I needed to jump something. Seven pillars of self-leadership. Number one, self-discovery. Self-discovery. Any person who never really truly discovers themselves cannot possibly maximize themselves. They can make money, but they can't maximize themselves. Self-leadership starts with self-discovery. Somebody say self-discovery. Knowing who you are, knowing certain things about yourself. Seven things quickly you need to know about yourself if you must start out in your journey of self-leadership. Number one, you need to know your person. Help me ask your neighbor, who are you? Okay, help me ask another person, do you know who you are? You need to know yourself. Praise the Lord. Have you seen some people? Some people are trying, you see some males, people, a guy trying to dress like a lady. She's wearing scarf. She's doing painting, everything, doing all. That's a very powerful of example of somebody who has very, very terrible self-esteem and self-misunderstanding. Are you still here? My prayer is that this month, the Holy Spirit will take you and introduce you to you. Amen. I didn't hear your amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, you need to understand yourself. Who are you? I'm a different person. Praise the Lord. You are different. Even if you are from the same womb, you can't possibly be the same in all ways. You know, I found out, it occurred to me one day and I checked it. Even Siamese twins are co-joined twins. They are joined either in their hand or in their brain. If you really analyze their lives, they are not the same persons. Now, that is very heavy. Siamese twins have been exposed to the same environment all their lives together. Am I communicating? But then, at the end of the day, if you really analyze them, they are two different persons. Somebody say, I'm a different person. You need to know who you are. In Genesis chapter 25, verse 27, Bible talking about Jacob and Esau. Remember, they were twins. Bible says, as they were growing up, Esau was, and the boys grew. Somebody say, the boys grew. And Esau was a cunning hunter, a man of the fields. One translation says, a man who loved the outdoors. And Jacob was a plain man. Somebody say plain man. And he loved dwelling in tents. Two different persons. Twins, but two different persons. Praise the Lord. If you never get a handle on who you are, you cannot begin to maximize life. Is somebody following me? Is somebody following me? In Luke chapter 4, verse 18, Jesus, the greatest leader who ever lived, from 18, I think, verse to 22 or 21, he began, the Spirit of the Lord is upon him. He walked into the synagogue one day and he took the book and then he found a place, Bible says, where it was written, and he began to read it. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to preach the gospel. And then he went on and on and on. Look at verse 21. Glory to Jesus. I said, glory to Jesus. And he began to say unto them, all these things I've read right now, he's the one standing before you. Praise the Lord. That's what 21 means. This day, this scripture is fulfilled in your ears. Jesus knew himself. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Self-leadership is the foundation of others' leadership. And then the foundation of self-leadership is self-discovery, understanding who you are. Praise the Lord. I said, praise God. God will help you and I. In the name of Jesus. Number two, still talking on self-discovery, you need to know what your purpose is. Why did you come here? My God will open your eyes and you will discover why you came. I didn't hear somebody's amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus, Luke chapter 4, verse 43, why did you come? If you never get to know it, you probably will never get to be in it or be involved with it. And then the person would have lived life, made a lot of money, and then died, yet they didn't maximize life. Praise the Lord.
And he said to them, talking about Jesus, the greater leader, we are going to use his example a whole lot. I must preach the kingdom of God to other cities also, for therefore am I sent. One of the reasons I came is to preach the gospel. Praise the Lord. Help me ask your neighbor, why did you come? And I thank God for the Holy Spirit. Help me tell your neighbor, walk with the Holy Ghost too. Say to another person, make sure you walk with the Holy Ghost. He said, I will lead you in the way you should go, and I will teach you to profit. Praise the Lord. I thank God for the Holy Spirit. I read medicine. Okay, and then I hung stethoscope. I wanted to do pastoring full time. And then one or the other, the Spirit of God brought me back into personal health management. And then this thing was gaining momentum. It was gaining momentum, and I didn't like it. Because in my mind, I wanted to be Dr. Chris, what hearing, praise the Lord. The one that does like this, and then people will fall under power. Glory to Jesus. And then 10 seats will break. Pastor Akin, on Monday, you will buy them again. And then, and then 10 persons will. That's honestly, I desire that. I quarrel with the Holy Spirit because of it. I said, Spirit of God, I don't like it too. Praise God. Every time I've been fasting, I want to see him move. Then during our quarrel one day, he said, but each time you are teaching, I'm already moving. Your own movement is to teach the word, let it move inside the heart of the people and change them. Glory to Jesus. And then he took me by the hand. I mean, if I don't have time to tell you how I got into personal health management. But, I mean, I thank God I did. Glory to Jesus. People are pursuing me all over the world just wanting to bless me because of it. I discovered a part. It's not my all my purpose, but it's a part and parcel of my purpose. Are you still here? You will discover your own purpose. I say you are going to discover your own niche. I didn't hear somebody say amen. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Samson's father asked, he prayed to God. He said, the man you sent to my wife while I was away, send them back. Okay, so the man came back, and then the woman said, that guy is here. He said, he was an angel. And he said, are you the one who spoke to my wife while I was not there? Don't be doing that again. That's not fair. Praise God, I should have been there. Hallelujah. Now, he said, concerning the son you said we will have, he said, what shall be his walk and his rule of life? What shall be his walk? And it was the angel who told him, he shall begin to deliver his people from the hands of the Philistines. Am I communicating? Okay, going through life without a purpose, without a knowledge of your assignment, is going towards disaster. Those kinds of persons are not in Enstone Church. I did not hear your amen. In the name of Jesus, the Spirit of God will take you by the hand and reveal your particular specific purpose to you. It will reveal the diverse aspects of it to you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord. You need to know your potentials. Your potential is what you could be that you have not yet become. Where you could go that you have not yet gone. Praise the Lord. The things you could accomplish that you have not yet accomplished. Your capacity, that's your potential. John chapter 8 verse 37. Pilate said, I told Jesus, he said, are you then a king? He said, you are correct by saying that you are very correct. He said, for this, John chapter, okay, praise the Lord. Chapter 18, verse 37. Praise the Lord. When Jesus has spoken these words, 37. Praise God, I'm trying to rush. 37. If you can find it, glory to God. Pilate therefore said to him, are you a king then? Jesus answered, you sayest that I am a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause came I into the world. This is why I came. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. This is why I came. You will discover why you came. In the name of Jesus, you will discover your possibilities. Your potentials is your possibilities. What you can accomplish that you have not accomplished yet. May you discover it. I said, may you discover it. And that early in the name of Jesus.
early enough in the name of Jesus. You need, in order to meet yourself into doing global, you need to be aware of your passion. What is your passion? My passion is teaching. Ah, Jesus, praise God. Sometimes I pity the Headstone Church people. I say, you want to teach these people to become professors. Praise the Lord. Glory to Jesus. Sometimes I have to say, oh, yeah, tone it down. It's not everybody who has teaching. When you have a teaching gift, you love knowledge a little bit less than you love your wife. Why are you laughing? Eh? I didn't see anything. Don't be knowing what I wanted to say. Praise the Lord. Teachers love knowledge. From an earliest age of my life, I came to understand that I have the teaching gift. It was many years. I think I was in year one, year two. That's first year in Med College of Medicine. We had a strike. I've forgotten which strike then. And then, so we gathered boys. We were just trying to fellowship, and then we said, let's share scripture. And then Pastor Uche said, let Chris share. I like it when he shares. I like the revelations he brings. I'm telling you. And you know, it was evident to me. It was evident to people around me. Praise the Lord. Listen to me. May God show to you your passion. I didn't hear your amen. In the name of Jesus. Not too long ago, I had to come to a place where he said, the rate at which you buy books, cool down, praise the Lord. Okay, at least the ones you have, read them. It was just too much. Is somebody still here? If you pass by my library, the person can, somebody can faint. Praise the Lord. It's something else. You will know your passion. Jesus said, I have a baptism to be baptized with. And how I wish it were already accomplished. The thing is burning me. I wish it were already done. Glory to Jesus. I said glory to Jesus. We are discussing self-mastery. Listen, when you know yourself, you become secured in yourself. Let every other person be doing anything. You are not moved. Am I communicating? Nothing moves you. Nothing. You are just there. They may own 10 cars. It doesn't bother you. Praise the Lord. They may own 20 houses. It doesn't bother you. Praise the Lord. When you know who you are and what you are created for, praise the Lord. Okay, you must know your partners. It's important you know your partners. By your partners, I mean your company. Who are you sent with? So know who you are sent to. Sorry, know what you are sent to do. The passion with which you are sent to pursue. And then you need to know the persons you are sent with. Your company. Bible says when they had that issue in Babylon, Daniel went to his company and then they held them together and prayed. When they scolded and threatened the apostles, Bible says they went to their company and then they prayed. Who are your companies? I see Christians running around with all kinds of people. People who don't have any bearing on their destination. Yeah, and it amazes me. You are not going in the same direction with these people. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. The persons that, after discovering who your partners are, your companies, you must stick with them. Not that you will not have relationships outside here and there, but your Reverend Sukomi, the last one was talking about church, was saying that there are some friends he has now that he met in church while we were churching. You remember? While we're churching, if you know what you are called to do and what you are called to accomplish, then you'll be able to decipher who your friends are. Praise the Lord. It's important. So part of self-mastery is master your partners and then master your priorities. John chapter 4 verse 34, master your priorities. If you must master yourself, you need to master your priorities. Somebody say my priorities. What are the things that are important to you? Jesus said to them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish the work. That's my meat. If I do that one, I'm satisfied. What gave rise to this statement? He was hungry. And Bible said they left him to go and buy him food. By the time they came, he was preaching.
And the preacher was turning from a sermon into a seminar. Praise the Lord. And then it was going becoming a workshop. Ah! Peter said, what is happening? Has somebody gone to get him food? He overheard them saying, they said, Peter, it's not like that. Nobody has gotten food for me. My food is to do, as long as I'm doing this will, so I am satisfied. Glory to Jesus. If a man does not respect his priorities, he begins to discountenance his life. Am I communicating? As a child of God, you must know what your priorities should be. And then as somebody in the marketplace with what you are sent, you must know what your priorities should be. Praise the Lord. Next one, you need to maximize self. You need to know the people you are sent to. Acts chapter 7, verse 23 to 24. The Bible says, and you know, he came into his house to visit his friends, talking about Moses, his people. Bible says, for it's Acts chapter 7, verse 23 to 24. He said, because he thought that they will understand how through his hand they will be delivered from slavery. He knew who he was sent to. Jesus knew who he was sent to. He said, I'm sent to the lost house of the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Those are the ones I'm sent to. Who are you sent to? Write it down. I think you should write it down, capital letter in your note. And then try and understand it. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Is somebody still here? Part of self-discovery. You need to understand your possessions, your skills, your talents, and then how to use them. I'm talking now personal health management, wellness. Still at the bottom is teaching. Are you still here? Still at the bottom is teaching. Just this grace to take something, elaborate it to people, make it clear. Praise the Lord. So self-discovery. Now let's run through another like five of it and then we'll stop. Next one should be self-development. How to pursue self-mastery, self-development. Giving yourself to development. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15, study to show yourself approved. Giving yourself to training. Committing to learning more and more. Glory to God. I said glory to Jesus. Committing to do what? Learning more and more. Write down Acts 18, 24 to 28. Acts 18, 28. 27, 28. Give us that one. It's the story of Apollos. Bible says he was mighty in words. And then, he was preaching the gospel most passionately. But Bible says he knew only the gospel of John. This was in Acts. Jesus had come and died and gone home. Praise the Lord. Somebody was still preaching. He was preaching the gospel of John. Then when Priscilla and Aquila heard him saying that, he had a lot of passion. Bible said they took him aside and then they taught him more accurately the things of the Spirit of the Lord. Praise God. And then they released him. And then, verse 27, they released him. Look at what happened, verse 27. And when he was disposed to pass into Asia, the brethren wrote, exhorting the disciples to receive him, who when he was come, he helped them much, which had believed through grace. He helped them much. And then 28, for he mightily convinced the Jews, and that publicly, showing by the scriptures that Jesus was Christ. Before now, he only knew the gospel of John the Baptist. But training, somebody say training. Say training. Don't joke with trainings. As I was teaching this, preparing this, it occurred to me, one simple example I will use. Were you here when Pastor Etoro was teaching our friends Connect recently? Doing a seminar, kind of workshop for people who are small-scale entrepreneurs and all that. And we're making lists of people who will teach there. Well, I said, Pastor Itoro can teach. She can teach exactly what she taught on structure. Praise the Lord. Now listen, somebody who understands, she has gone to Faith Foundation. She has gone to LBS. Now, every friend's connect, if she's in town, she's sitting here. Are you still here? That kind of person should not be in that class if it's the normal way people think. Well, I don't need it. It amazes me. The rate at which people cannot give themselves to getting the things that they need. Somebody's trying to build a business. Somebody's trying to build a career. Every Sunday, we're talking around it. Itoro is seated. I'm seated. Praise the Lord. And I know some little things. I'm telling you, I know some little things. I'm seated. And I'm learning. People are out. They have not gone home. Follow me, my lolly. They are outside there, gisting. Ha! Kabolo robolo. Eshe. Sin. Sin against destiny. Sin. Praise God. Is somebody still here? Don't do that. Somebody still said it yesterday. I am not happy with any person who is a business person in this church and you don't make friends connect. I'm not happy with you. I'm not happy. Esther, God said to tell you that you are frustrating his efforts in your life if you are doing that. Yes, you are. Is somebody still here? Two more or three. I'll just name the rest. Seven pillars of self-leadership. Number one, self-discovery. We elaborated on that. Number two, self-development. Giving yourself to training. Learning more and more. These books that we produce each one, the bigger ones, for 4,000 naira. 3.9 something thousand. And then it occurred to me, why should we be giving money to people like this? When we can buy the machine and then be doing the printing ourselves. On Saturday, or when was that? I bought the machine, praise God. I said, praise God. From 8 a.m. to 2 p.m., if you see one small cubicle in Mowe where I was, people were coming, a business center, the guy uses the machine. They said, go to that person, he will teach you. He was teaching me how to use the machine. Glory to God. Somebody say training. By the time he finished teaching me, and then he gave me the prices and all that, we went to buy papers yesterday. What we printed for 4,000, it's possible we're able to bring it out for 2,000 naira. Am I communicating? I can learn anything. To hell with the devil. Praise the Lord. And I'm not the one who will be going. Somebody say, when will you have time to be doing it? It's just to call one person and download what I learned on him. That's why I'm going my way. That's why we're able to do several things. And people are doing it for us. Glory to Jesus. Don't neglect life like that. Try. So next one is discipline. Discipline is character. Being able to push yourself to do the things you must do. An area I would like to talk on there is punctuality, promptness, joy. Praise God. That stand up, joy. Very fantastic lady. Put your hands together. Please help me celebrate her. She's the person who literally helped us locate that facility. And she's on the forefront. So we needed to see the landlord recently. I think it was Wednesday by 9. By 8:30, she called me. She said, Pastor Moti wanta. Ah. I said, cool down, praise the Lord. You know, and then sit down, Joy. So we were still waiting for a couple of persons to come. Eventually, and then some clients came to see me. We delayed her. Around 9:16, we left. But you know, and then she said something. I like to be punctual. That's what she said. She said, because if you are not like that, people may take you to be unserious. You know why I'm using this example? Joy is a woman. Uche. Uche saw that. She's a woman. That you're a woman. God didn't create lateness with women. Earthstone will be 17 years by December. From inception, if you count how many times the first three persons who are in Sunday service or in SLC, I am one of them. That's if I'm coming and if I'm in town. 17 years. Yesterday, by 5:30, we're already here. Praise the Lord. Are you still here? Don't you meet me here when you come for service on Sunday morning? It's called discipline, sir. Am I communicating? Sunday service, 9, and then you and your husband will start fighting. Every anointing will turn to annoyance. Pastor Chris will be talking. You are no, you can't hear. All manners. Can you stop that? Can you stop it? If you are not able to get yourself to do things when you should do it, then when to get to a place where you should get there. In which other places will you be able, areas will you be able to get yourself to do things you need to do? Praise the Lord. Which other places? Indiscipline, procrastination. Out of the window in the name of Jesus. Out of the window. Available shut. I will say this and I will close. I was in a seminar and Bookie Health Plus, Bookie George was training. She said she had an encounter in one of the training. No, I think it was in, we brought her to Headstone Church. And then she said that one of her mentors is a Dangote. And that she was in a training. Dangote came to take a lecture in LBS. And he was telling them that he sleeps around 1 a.m. or thereabout every day. By like that 4 or 5, he has woken up. Then he will do his prayers. Then he will do this. Then he will do this. Then he will hold meetings. She said, so you hold meetings? I said, I hold meetings. It's just that the meetings I hold with the MDs of my conglomerates. And then by 1, I am going to bed. 5 a.m., I'm awake. So all that is building massive structures. It's discipline, sir. Another name for it is discipline. Praise God. I'll just add the remaining ones and then you can build upon it. Praise the Lord. Discipline, diligence, denial, self-denial, delayed gratification, determination, doggedness, and then deployment, capacity to release yourself. To break into new frontiers. Praise the Lord. You are blessed. Listen to me. There's greatness trapped on your inside. And I prophesy this morning to that greatness to come out in the name of Jesus. I'm not hearing your amen. I'm not hearing your amen. In the name of Jesus. I prophesy and I speak to your potentials and your possibilities to receive life in the name of Jesus. Receive life. Begin to flow up. Begin to well up. In the name of Jesus, your generation will enjoy you. I say your generation will enjoy you. They will enjoy of your ministry. They will enjoy of your giftings. They will enjoy of your passion. They will enjoy of your dealings with them. In the name of the Lord Jesus. In many places, people will know you. And they will know you for good. They will know you celebrating you. In the name of Jesus. After some time now, everywhere, in every corner of the world, people will be making prayers for you. Your name will be a household name. For good, not for evil. People praying for you. Begging God on your behalf. pleading God on your behalf. So shall it be. And the people shouted. Amen. God bless you. Thank you so very much.